So I'm very happy to be here in front of you in this special place. It is the land where my Guru Swami Vishnavananda born, and where he started somehow this journey of peace and sharing that peace and the knowledge of yoga to the whole world. So I came here several times, and when I came the first time, it was not the way that you are experienced now. You know, it was just a few huts. It was very, very simple, actually. But Swamiji puts lots of love in this place. And, you know, all the people, they attract for this love and the energy he put here. So that's the reason you are here. I'm very surprised. So many people and so many diseases you have picked up.
Four.
I know this is like this. Okay, it's more usually. I came once that they have 203. And it was amazing because they have all languages here. And I was doing the translation of the teaching from the Spanish group. And it was nice because, you know, after this course, I was at the airport in Mumbai. And some people approached to me, "Oh, yeah, Kanti Devi, you know, I was in the TDC with you, where I was in Kerala, 200 people, so how can I remember you?" There's no way, you know, it's very, very difficult. But somehow it's beautiful, the energy you all put here in order to make it possible. Because we all know, we went through, and honestly, I can tell you, we go through every time you have to teach at TDC, for all the things you go through too. Now you're in the third week, they said it is worse. It's tough, you know, you have carrying, and then you have anatomy. I hope the classes are doing well for you. But for most of the people, I know it's not an easy thing, and we are not used to study that way, so it gets an effort. But the way some Vishnavananda put it together, he needed for all of us to make an effort. And that effort we are putting here, it's just a very tiny thing compared with the effort we have to do when we call the real world, when you have to go out of this gate and to keep your life, to work, and to do all the things. It's a lot of effort. But you are so used to that you don't complain much, I hope. But when you come to TDC, usually there is lots of complaints. So you complain? Yes, not too much. I don't think you complain much. That's nice. But usually I teach in South America, different countries there. There's a lot of complaining, you know, just sitting on the floor, just the food, and so many, like, no information, you know, and it's not easy. But Swamiji did it in a way for all of us to do this effort, but he put such a love in the teachings that made it possible. And we will be teaching this for many, many, many years now. So I started yoga when I was 15 years old, a long time ago. But I just want to mention something, the way I met him. Like, we can say it's not a really usual thing, because I didn't meet him personally. I was in Uruguay, in South America. It was 1969. And we were ready to receive a Swami from India, and he was invited to come to South America, especially to Uruguay, to teach yoga. And this Swami was invited, it was Swami Chidananda, who was the director of the Divine Life Society. He was not at that time, but he was for a while. He passed away now. So my yoga teacher was very weird to practice yoga at that time. You know, but I had a yoga teacher at that time. I said, okay, we go to the airport. And we would just welcome this person from India, you know, offering some flowers in the name of the Gurubais. And, you know, they have so many Gurubais. I'm sure, you know, some of the teachers talk to you about them during this course. So when the teacher was offering the flowers to all his her students, the words said to me, "You will offer in the name of," and she said, "Swami Vishnavananda." And it was, was so special, that name, that touched my heart. So my head, my whole body started like shaking. He says, I want to know him. Who's that? Who's the person? Please tell me. Just be quiet. Behave, you know. I had to offer the flowers to somebody. She's like, no. I want to know. Who's him? And I was like, I was 15 years old at that time, so you maybe can comprehend me, but it was difficult for me just to be there at the end of that situation, just to know who was him. And then, just to show me him, she brought the book, the illustrated book of yoga, the book where you are studying. And then it was amazing just to see all the postures. I wanted to do everything. So I mentioned that because sometimes we don't pay attention to the language with the words we're using among us and the regular world where we live together. And imagine the effect just a name make in a life of a person. So how the words affect us all the time. So how, if we get the energy of those names, you know, we can really make a big difference in our lives. So I'm telling this thing to you because sometimes we don't pay much attention to the things we say or we just say. But the name of some relation to another for me is so sacred, you know, so special, so lovely, because from that moment till now, he's here. He's with me. And then, of course, so many things pass in the middle. So, but I was too young and very far away. I don't know if you know where Uruguay is. Most of the people, they don't know. Maybe they know through those famous football players, or they know in Argentina, things like that. But it's far away from here. It took 36 hours to get there. That's the reason I was like off for 2 days. I couldn't do much. But anyway, so, and then I started writing to some issues with Ananda. At that time, we didn't have all this WhatsApp and all the mails and nothing. And I had to write. I was writing, and then wait like 17 days to the letter reach Swamiji, and then another 17 days to the answer. So if he will answer right away. So the first letter I got is, come to the house to do DDC. But at that age, it was something completely impossible. Like thinking, okay, I will go to the moon, something like that. So it was not easy. It took me time to go, but then I did it. So when I went to Bahamas, I met him personally first time. It was 1975. It took 6 years. So now for young people that they want everything fast, immediately, you know, things take time. But it's good sometimes to wait a bit. And then when I saw him, when I arrived to the ashram the first time, some Vishnu came to me in a short pants and a t-shirt. He didn't wear like Indian at that time. He was trying to adapt, you know, to the West. And he came to me, he approached, and I was ready to do all that thing because I there with Swamiji Dananda, you know, to say namaskar, regular thing for you here, but in South America it's not like that. When you just receive a person, you kiss them, and then you hug the person, and tight. Not like in North America, they do like this. Hug the people. So I was ready to say to Swamiji like this. And suddenly, he has the most beautiful smile, you know. His smile was like a sunrise. It was so nice. And then he came, and he said, oh, also, yeah, he said my name, my real name. Also, you came from South America. He always said South America. He never said the country I came from. So it looked like he was saying, come from South America, is what I feel. Not a specific country. And then he had me. I was my hands like this. I kissed my cheek and I was completely shocked because how it comes. But at that moment I felt home. I could be like with my father, my brothers, or my sisters, or whatever. You didn't understand. Because the trip was very long to get there. And you feel, you know, the emotions, you know, the emotions. I think all over the world, the emotions, they play with us all the time. It was so beautiful, so, so beautiful. And since that, you know, I just got a connection that it was not from that moment. We knew was from before. So we had so many experiences together during that ADC. And then, I don't have much time to talk, so I had to finish by 7:30, before 7:30. So, during that TDC, he wanted to do a peace mission. So, I was the only person speaking Spanish at the ashram at that time. And he wanted to visit Cuba, because he said, Cuba, the people are suffering there, and I need help there, I need a translator. Can you come as translator with me? And he said, well, somebody asks you something, you will say immediately, yes. I learned not to Nataraj, because I didn't say yes. But for Swami, there was no doubt. You would say yes. You don't know what you are saying, but you said yes. But we have a very difficult problem. We have a difficulty there, because in my country there was military government. And of course, they had no relations with, diplomatic relations with Cuba at that time. So it was very risky and dangerous for me to travel there. But Swamiji wants me to ask permission first to my mother. Everything I did at the time, he said, ask permission to your mother. Amazing. Because now you don't ask permission to anyone. You just want to do whatever you want. But he says, just first ask your mother. He shall ask you to do it. I imagine my mother who would say, no, you cannot go. Just to that, just for you and for the family. Imagine if they know you're in Cuba. You know, the whole family can be arrested. I put in jail, what usually happened at that time. But I call her so many times that at the end she said, do whatever you want. And for me it was the most beautiful yes I could hear in my life. So when I was starting to get so wet, your mother said, she said, yes. So it was, you know, it was like that. So we started arranging everything to go. And then it became a very difficult situation because we have no embassy in Bahamas, and we have no Uruguayan embassy in Cuba. And of course, we had to go through Washington to get a permission for you to go to Cuba. So the first time I talked to someone, I said, you are crazy, you cannot go there because you know you will be in jail. Maybe they cannot allow you to go out. Or if you get to your country, if you scan your passport, you'll be there, you cannot get into your country anymore. But I didn't pay attention to those things, you know. So I said, okay, you say no, there is no way, why was he? Just call again, and he gave me a number. So I called one day to that number. I think it was too late. And someone answered. The person says, there is no problem, you can go anyway. But I didn't ask the name of that person. So I took it like, you know, it would be no problem to go there. So when somebody came, he came from New York, he says everything is ready to go. So can we go? So we took his plane. Have you been in Canada? Have you been at the headquarters? Valmarie, well, I have to go there. Make sure one day you will go there. So we say, one day we will come to India to learn yoga. So one day you have to go to Canada. That's to be at his place. It was the first place where he started this organization. So so he came from New York and says, okay, everything is, the plane is there. He learned how to play, to fly a plane. And we flew from Bahamas to Miami. And from there we flew to La Habana, Cuba. And it was very interesting because in that the plane was full of flowers and full of leaflets, just talking about the all religions, you know, and talking about peace. It was very, very beautiful. So we did all the prayers and everything, and we started a flight to La Habana. And then in the middle of the flight, suddenly he says, Kanti Devi, I need to meditate. And he did it very seriously. and said, "Do you know how to fly?" I don't even know how to drive a car, so I don't know how to fly a plane. So that, anyway, you're my co-pilot. You need to know. But I don't know. You don't know, just get the wheel, look in front, make sure nothing comes in front of us, and pray. So was my flying lessons was like this. So that way, you know, I was shaking. I was just full of fear. I didn't know what to do. My eyes were so wide open. So I was there and I was praying a lot. And the image of Swami Shivananda came very easily to me in that moment. And Swamiji crossed his leg and just dropped the wheel. I started his meditation and I was there. I said, what's going to happen, you know? But suddenly, you know, you start having contact with the airport in Havana. And when that thing happened, Swamiji came out with his meditation, took the wheel, because I had to translate for him because they were speaking Spanish. And they say, you are not allowed to be in our sky. We don't allow planes coming from the States. You have to go back.
Oh, so
sad. But Swamiji, you know what he said? Tenderly enough. That's what he said. Chakras, this is radio. And so I did it. I put it off, and then we start repeating Andre Yamaga, Andre Yamaga, Andre. But Nanda is shoot to us, Nanda say anything like that. So we land in Yamaga. When we land there, so Swami says, get the flowers, get the leaves, get all those things. And then lots of people, you know, soldiers came to us with those machine guns in their hands, pointed. And Swamiji was a beautiful, like it was the most beautiful welcome to him. He said, give the flowers to everyone. Swamiji said, yes, give the flowers. And he was very strong, very strong. He says, okay, so it was like this, give the flowers. The guys, they took the flowers. And the moment they took the flowers, those machines started to come down to the floor. And they kept it. I was so, I cannot forget in my life, you know, that picture. The guys with the guns and with the flower. And Swamiji with a smile talking about Shivananda, yoga, Baba, everything. And the guys were like, because he was speaking English, he didn't understand, it was trying to translate, it was too fast. So it was just in the middle of all that thing, and they lost. But they all got guns. And they said, okay, get again your guns. But they didn't let the flower come down. They kept the flower, they kept the guns. And then just to, I mentioned always this part because, you know, for me it was the most important. Swamiji wasn't afraid. In his heart, he wanted to share, you know, the knowledge of yoga to help them in their life because they knew they were suffering. So he cannot be stopped for that. Do you understand? And if you are not in fear, you don't feel it. So the people, they feel relaxed. They are not in fear there. And it's something just beautiful that he was teaching to us all the time. He was not in fear. He did what he had to do, but not in fear. And he did all the time in the name of his guru. Was not personal recognition of that. I will not because I did Swami or I this and that. No, just in his name. And all the time he approached to anyone, he would do it in his name. You know? And that was beautiful. Unfortunately, we couldn't understand it. But we did, he said, get ready for the asana demonstration. And we did the lecture. But Swamiji were at the airport. We are at the airport. They don't allow us to go out. Just we give the lecture here. So he starts with the 5 points. And you know the 5 points by now. And then the asana demonstration and this and that, talking about yoga, blah, blah, blah. So finally they say, you have to go. You can only stay here. So it's a long story and I made it short because we have some other classes to go on. But this experience is just the teaching of that Swamiji, when he has something in his mind and his heart is pure, you know, trying to help others, he will do it. He will do it. I'm telling all those things for you because very soon you will be your teachers. Your teacher. And then we will continue this school. So you will teach in the name of Swami Shivananda, in the name of Swami Vishnu Devananda. And something I would like just to make sure you remember, just keep the teachings pure. It's very difficult and very hard to find nowadays the teachings pure. Everybody wants to mix with everything. Also of yours all around the world. I don't know why you get the certificates and you become so creative. I want the yoga with this, I want the yoga with that, with the music, with that. So many things. Just keep this purity because Swamiji told the way it was said to him. And we are trying, we are making the effort to keep it that way too. Because you, when you do it that way, you contact with a lineage that is not a stop. Every time you want to add your personal things, you will somehow you will cut that lineage. Just keep on in practice. And everything was taught here, it was according to their teachings. And it's for us, it's good for us. But it will be good for also for other people. And you can help along humanity just with the teachings of yoga. Thank you.